Uzbekistan with a y'all not doing that part, are you? That's that one little da-da-da-da-da-da-da where the winds may blow.
Let's see if we can figure it out.
Yeah. Hope not. We're not going to do it.
So you're saying don't do it?
You want us to do it?
If you do it, I need
to. We usually do it.
Okay, if you do it, then that's fine. I will let the singer know.
Okay.
Because normally, last time when she played, sung with y'all didn't do that part. And y'all automatically started it through her office. So I just want to make sure if you do it, then I'm going to let her know y'all going to do it.
Okay.
Okay. So y'all going to do it?
Yeah.
Okay, perfect.
Okay.
That's all
you
do. Oh, yeah.
It's
Wiggins is shot. He said he's done all he can do.
Oh, yeah, done. The processional and the concessional.
Wait a minute.
So y'all want to switch off?
I brought another set of chops in my backpack.
What happened to.
We'll start right at 8.
I think the chops are
okay.
We started.
At the beginning of 8.
At the very, very beginning.
Okay.
Chumper's Road came with the very beginning.
I showed it when I
was in Chumper's. Beginning of the intro.
By the way, on Pomp and Circumstance, while we're looking at
Mr. Magic to the greatest.
Remember, we start, we play A all the way down. We do the first inning. It goes back to B. Then we take the optional ending, and it goes back to A. We DS back to A.
Yep.
And we do that a zillion times. The only time we'll ever play that second ending at the bottom
that'll never
is
happen.
If we make it.
Right, because
it'll
be
the finale.
It'll be cut off somewhere in the middle.
Yeah.
Okay,
it'll probably be cut off somewhere.
No. He stopped music. The guy stopped us. Right?
Oh, yeah, they'll always stop us. Huh?
No, the guy stopped us. He came down the aisle. So.
And remember, it's key change. Watch the key changes in the middle of it.
Don said we don't have to worry about key changes.
It's all clear. They're the key. Don
said we don't
have to
worry about key changes.
No.
Okay. So
that's
where
calamity starts.
And he told you
I guess they want us to start the session.
We got just any or anything.
Like, Tom is the leader right here.
Okay, so at the very beginning.
Ladies and gentlemen, good morning, and welcome to the 2021 Spring Commencement Program of Harris Stowe State University. My name is Dr. LaTanya Collins-Smith, and I have the distinct pleasure of serving as the Provost and Vice President of Academic Affairs here at Harris Stowe State University, and I am also your Grand Marshal for this year's commencement ceremony. Please welcome Mrs. Antoinesha Murray, valedictorian for the class of 2021, who is carrying the university's official mace. At the sounding of the trumpets, the 2020-2021 Faculty Member of the Year, Ms. Dr. Wendell Brooks, Assistant Professor of Chemistry, and Dr. Amber Jones, Assistant Professor of Education, and this year's honorary marshals will escort faculty, staff, and guests to their seats. Thank you. The marshals will now escort members of the Harris Stowe State University Board of Regents, presidents, and other platform guests. And now, the marshals will escort the graduating class of 2021 into the gymnasium. Let's give them all a round of applause. Will everyone please stand for the presentation of the colors and singing of the national anthem by the St. Louis Metropolitan Police Department.
By the dawn's early light, what so proudly we've hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight o'er the ramparts we've watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still. Star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave, the home of the home of the
It is now my pleasure to introduce Reverend Tracy D. Blackman, Associate General Minister, Justice, and of Local Church Ministries for the Church of God in Christ, who will give us the invocation. Reverend Blackman.
Let us pray. God of grace and mercy, we invite your presence into this space today. As family, faculty, administrators, community, and friends have come together to celebrate the accomplishments of the graduating class of 2021 and to hear the petitions on our hearts today. Today we give thanks for the sheer magnificence of their minds. By thinking, by the sublime rippling of the muscles of thought, people like Anna Julia Cooper and Baldwin and Du Bois and Lord and Fanon and King have unleashed not the armies of history, but the power of ideas to change the world. Who knows what lies ahead in the lives of those gathered today? For the sweet taste of accomplishment in a world that persistently asks, "What have you done for me lately?" We are here to celebrate hard work completed and done well. Allow this to be a time of great joy and celebration. For sacrifices made by others, most of us have not made it here alone. These significant ones, many of them present today, will walk this stage in spirit with these that graduate. for the sacrifices made by the graduates themselves. They have shown dedication through their studies, hours in the library, and the many spaces on campus in study groups and group projects, and the all-nighters turned into last-moment but on-time papers. Through the sweat and tears and shouts of joy and completion, we give thanks for what may be the most difficult work they have done to this point in their life. And we ask today for your blessing on these, our graduates. Bless them with passion. Let them move out from this day, not into jobs, but into a calling. Let them live for their passions, their talents, and their gifts, and take every opportunity to put these to good use in creating a better tomorrow. Bless them with a sense of responsibility. Remind them that they have a contribution to make to create change and create a better world in whatever places they find themselves. That as graduates, they are now people of privilege, charged to use that privilege responsibly and not to as a deterrent to others. Bless them with humility. Help them to live not in excessive pride, but in ways that lift the values of equity and equality for all humanity, that seek to not only lift up themselves, but seeks to lift all others up as well. And finally, bless them with a legacy. These today will mark the world, whether they are trying to or not. Let the shadow of their mark stretch far beyond their liabilities and limitations. Let them know the rich satisfaction, not of merely making a living, but of living a life, full, rich, and deep. For all these things and so much more, I lift this prayer in the name of the one I serve, in the name of Jesus the Christ. Amen.
Graduates and guests, you may be seated. I would like to take this time to introduce members of our platform party. Please hold your applause until each name has been called. To my right, Mrs. Vanessa Cooksey, President and CEO of the Regional Arts Commission and Vice Chair of the Board of Regents. I would also like to acknowledge our Board of Regent members who are not able to be in attendance with us today. Attorney Ronald A. Norwood of Lewis Rice and Chairman of the Board of Regents, Ms. Christine Chadwick, member of the Board of Regents and former Executive Director of Focus St. Louis, Ms. Deborah Hollingsworth, member of the Board of Regents and former Vice President for External Affairs for AT&T, Mr. Michael P. McMillan, President and CEO of the Urban League of Metropolitan St. Louis and Board of Regent member, Ms. Antoinesha Murray, valedictorian for the class of 2021. Mrs. Caitlin Chandler, Senior Class Treasurer. Dr. Odessa Weatherford Jacobs, Faculty Senate President. Ms. Shirley Brown, President of the Harris Stowe State University Alumni Association. Dr. Corey S. Bradford, President of Harris Stowe State University. Mr. Darren Henson, our commencement speaker. Dr. Edward Hill Jr., Associate Provost for Academic Affairs. Once again, Reverend Tracy D. Blackman. Dr. Stacy G. Hollins, Dean of the Anheuser-Busch School of Business. Dr. Terry Daly Davis, Interim Dean of the College of Arts and Science. Let's give them all a round of applause. Will all members of the Harris Stowe Executive Cabinet please stand? Let's give them a round of applause. You may be seated. Will all members of the Harris Stowe State University faculty, staff, and alumni please stand? Let's give them a round of applause. You may be seated. Let me also take a moment to introduce the First Lady of Harris Stowe State University, Dr. Josette Bradford. Please stand. It is now my honor to present at this time Dr. Corey S. Bradford, the 20th president of Harris Stowe State University, who will bring welcoming remarks. Dr. Bradford.
Thank you, Dr. Colin Smith. And it is a great day to be a Hornet. Come on, give it up, Hornets! To the graduates of the class of 2021, Harris Stowe faculty, staff, students, and members of the Board of Regents, government officials, distinguished guests, alumni, and beloved family members and friends, I say good morning and welcome to Harris Stowe State University. This is our spring graduation ceremony for the class of 2021. The commencement ceremony stands as one of our proudest moments at Harris Stowe. It is when the campus community comes together to celebrate the many accomplishments of our graduates. As the 20th president of Harris Stowe, it is my honor to be able to address our graduating seniors today. To the graduating class of 2021, today is your new start. It is a new chapter in your life. It is the start of being an alumni of this great university we call Harris Stowe. And so we thank you for choosing us to complete your college education. Also, we say congratulations to you, and your presence here today defines what it truly means to be a success. Graduates, as a university, our top priority is your success. Our purpose is to educate you, to develop you, and to prepare you to be ready for the world. And we know that you are ready to enter the workforce. We know that you are ready to enter graduate school. We know that you are also ready to be great community leaders and citizens. And for this preparation, we say thank you to our wonderful, wonderful faculty and staff who have been there for you thick and thin as you go through this journey. So today lets me know that each one of you have done what you have set out to do, and that is to learn, that is to earn your degree, and to leave Harris Stowe a better person. And so at this time, I would like to share with you two stories of our graduates who are a true testament to the perseverance and pursuit of academic excellence that embodies the Harris Stowe experience. The first student is Elizabeth Berger. Elizabeth is a senior majoring in biology. She came to Harris Stowe because she appreciated the downtown location. She also liked that it was an affordable university and she felt at home when she was here at the university. Ms. Berger currently works as a student worker in the Office of the President. She is also a teaching assistant here at Harris Stowe. In addition, she maintains a 3.9 GPA, okay? She is also a member of Phi Theta Kappa National Society Leadership and Success, and is one of our outstanding graduates here with us today. And this fall, Elizabeth will be attending Washington University right here in St. Louis to obtain her master's degree in engineering. And so we are so proud of her accomplishment. And Elizabeth, can you please stand so we can congratulate you? Thank you, thank you. Next, we have Ms. Jamira Jones, who is a senior majoring in criminal justice with a concentration in juvenile justice. Ms. Jones serves as Harris Stowe Miss Senior. She also served as the sophomore class president. She's a student ambassador, she's a computer technology tutor, she's a model, and she's a mentor for the St. Louis Public School Finish Line program. Upon graduating from high school, she enrolled in one of Harris Stowe's Summer Bridge programs. It was during this program that she was able to earn additional credits for college. So today, Jamira is graduating from Harris Stowe in only 3 years. Let's give it up to Jamira. She blazed the trail while she was here at Harris Stowe. Jamira, can you stand? Congratulations. Thank you so much. These are just two examples of our notable graduates. There are many, many more stories that I could have told about the successful graduates we have today. And I have no doubt that they will all go on to have an impact on this world and this nation. And so to all of you who are graduating today, know that your accomplishment is something worthy of celebrating. You have completed a rigorous course of study amid a global health pandemic, okay? You have charted your path. You have achieved skills that will make you stand out wherever you go. So thank you for being resilient. Thank you for being patient. And thank you for being flexible. And as I conclude today my remarks, I would be remiss if I did not acknowledge many people who supported you on your personal journey here. I'm referring to your parents. I'm talking about mom and dad. Give them a hand clap. I'm talking about your grandparents, your spouses, your partners, your children and your siblings, your aunts and your uncles, your mentors and your friends. And to all the mothers and fathers, we say thank you for enduring your daughters and sons to us here at Harris Stowe. And we are just one day before Mother's Day. And so graduates, I need you all to look at your mothers. Graduates, I need you all to say what? Happy Mother's Day. What a present. Give them a hand clap, class. Class of 2021, you have earned our sincerest congratulations, and we wish you nothing but the best. So help you God. Thank you. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Dr. Bradford. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in welcoming the Vice Chairman of the Harris Stowe State University's Board of Regents, Mrs. Vanessa Cooksey. Regent Cooksey.
Good morning. Good morning. On behalf of the Harris Stowe State University Board of Regents, I bring you greetings. Thank you to everyone who put in the time and effort to make today possible. This is our favorite day of the year, Being able to participate in commencement is why we volunteer, unpaid, and give our countless time and talent to Harris Stowe. This is my 7th graduation. The last one was virtual, so I'm even more excited to be here with you today, safely, to celebrate. I am hugging you with my words and wishing you the best kind of freedom as you pursue your life goals, being debt-free, disease-free, and drama-free. Your unique college experience includes a complete upending of our social, financial, and environmental norms during a global environmental norms caused by COVID-19. Earning your degree during a global pandemic is no small feat. We salute your creativity and sheer perseverance in getting to the finish line. For you, this is not just a culmination of college. It's a time to honor the years that you spent juggling multiple priorities, demands, and jobs, the long nights finishing your assignments, and the overall sacrifices that led to the degree you earned today. Now, you get to thank the people that help you through this process and rejoice with your Harris Stowe friends, faculty, and staff. As a HSSU alum, you will have more career options than non-graduates. The demand for skilled and degreed talent is higher today than even a year ago. Your Harris Stowe degree offers you more flexibility in where, when, and how you choose to work and serve your community. I want you to know that we are so very proud of you, and we are expecting more great things from you. We applaud you for a job well done, and on behalf of the Board of Regents, our thoughts and prayers are with you. Congratulations.
Thank you, Regent Cooksey. Now, we will hear from the valedictorian of the class of 2021, Ms. Antoinesha Murray. Let's give her a hand. Applause.
Good morning, family and friends, faculty and staff, the Board of Regents, and fellow classmates. First, I would like to say welcome to the moment we've all been waiting for. Happy graduation and congratulations to you all. Do me a favor, pull out your camera, look at yourself. Take a selfie and congratulate yourself because you're not the same person you were when you first started. You've grown, and like Harris Stowe State University, which was once Harris Teacher College for white students only in 1857, you have evolved into the person you are today, and that alone is something to celebrate. Give yourself credit for the days you thought you could not make it, the days you thought you could not do it. We've all had different journeys. We've matriculated through college and fought to obtain our degrees. Some of you are still fighting, and that's okay. Keep going. Trust me, I know. I have lost family, friends, been depressed, stressed, changed my major a few times, but I'm here. We're here. As Maya Angelou said, we may encounter many defeats, but we must not be defeated. I want to thank my parents for helping me get through college. My mom and my stepdad are my rock. Thank you both for keeping me on my toes and pushing me beyond my limits, no matter what the circumstances were. Like some of you, I did not start my journey here at Harris Stowe State University, but I'm finishing here, or at least this chapter. My support system is something serious. From family and friends, they have all been there for me. Thank whoever helped you get through this journey, whether it was advice, tutoring, guidance, a hot meal, financial support, or a shoulder to cry on. If you did it all on your own, pat yourself on the back because we know it could not have been easy. Anything is possible when you set your mind to it. I managed to get a full-ride presidential scholarship to college, transfer, get another scholarship that helped me earn my bachelor's degree today. I'm just a little black girl from East St. Louis in the projects, Illinois. I'm just a little black girl from the projects in East St. Louis, Illinois, who was able to beat the odds with the statistics stacked against me. And because of that, I plan to spread my black girl magic and leave my mark in every room I step foot in. No matter the obstacles you've endured, you're here now, and that's all that matters. We're a generation built on being different. We proved people wrong, overcame obstacles and adversity. Throughout my time in college, I worked two jobs, remained very involved in campus organizations, and served as a student athlete as a hairstyle cheerleader, and those 6 a.m. practices were not a joke. The Academic Resource Center was my best friend when I first transferred to Harrisville State University and during the global pandemic. I would also like to give a special shout out to the audacious Alpha Omega Citywide Chapter of Delta Sigma Theta Sorority Incorporated for welcoming me into the best sorority for me. Last semester wasn't easy, but it was definitely worth it. If you're Greek, you know that you can always call on your LS, your LB, your soror, or your frat whenever you need them. I've gained 47 beautiful, intelligent, and dedicated sisters that I know will show up if I need them. Thank you to SGA and Pre-Law Society for allowing me to serve you. I am a mentee as well as a mentor. Thank you, Dr. Colin Smith and Mrs. Burnett for all the opportunities and resources. I believe that the sky is literally the limit, and that we can do anything we set our minds to as long as we plan for it. I make long-term goals and use my short-term goals to accomplish them. This is my second time graduating valedictorian of my class. I cannot have done that without my support system. My parents, family, and friends, I want to say thank you again. Love your family and friends while they're here, because tomorrow is not promised, and you never know when's the last time you are here or see from someone. I've lost so many people since I've started this journey, but I know they're proud looking down on me on all of my accomplishments today, and so are your loved ones. When they ask you what's next after college, simply reply, the next level. Whether that means obtaining your master's degree, starting your own career, or owning your own business, it's okay to move at your own pace as long as you move forward while doing it, because the world stops for no one and time waits for no one. Theodore Roosevelt said, do what you can with all you have wherever you are. Always put your best foot forward. Do better, be better, and make a difference for the generations to come. You will be held accountable for the decisions you make this day forward. I'll leave you with my favorite quote, and you can think to yourself about what that means for you. It is our duty to fight for our freedom. It is our duty to win. We must love each other and support each other. We have nothing to lose but our chains. Congratulations again, graduates. You did it.
Amazing. Antoinesha is just an example of what we call the Harrisville magic. And Antoinesha, I met her 3 years ago when she was a student at her other school. And she transferred to Harrisville, and she told me when she transferred that she was going to be the valedictorian. She was the valedictorian of her high school class of 2017 in East St. Louis High School. And 4 years later, she is the valedictorian of Harrisville State University. We will now hear from our senior class treasurer, Ms. Caitlin Chandler. Let's give her a round of applause.
morning to the Board of Regents, faculty, staff, parents, and my fellow Spring 2021 graduates. Today is truly an amazing day to be a Hornet. As this journey comes to an end, I am happy to say that we made it. Through every obstacle, hurdle, roadblock, and even a global pandemic, we made it. As a class, I can say we've been through a lot. Championships, conference tournaments, water balloon fights, parties, kickbacks, hard classes, easy classes, a pandemic, and much more. But as a renowned football coach, Vince Lombardi, once said, the price of success is hard work, dedication to the job at hand, and the determination that whether we win or lose, we have applied the best of ourselves to the task at hand. Although we've been through a lot, the important part is that we didn't give up. We persevered, even when it seemed as if the odds were against us. We made it to the finish line. I would like to give a special, special thanks to Dr. Bailey and Dr. Isel and many of my other professors who helped me along the way. Without them, this journey would be impossible. I would like to thank my family, my beautiful grandmother, my friends and hairstyle faculty and staff who helped me reach this defining moment. And I encourage you all to thank those who helped you along to get to this big day. Thank them sincerely, because without them and God, none of this would be possible. As this journey comes to an end, I can honestly say that I am beyond grateful for attending such a wonderful institution that helped me shape me into the woman I am today. HSSU will always have a very special place in my heart. I'm proud of every single one of you. It's so exciting to be in a room full of today's and tomorrow's lawyers, chemists, mathematicians, entrepreneurs, teachers, and much more. Go out there and show the world what Harrisstowe graduates can do and sprinkle a little of that Harrisstowe magic everywhere you go. And as always, it's a great day to be a Hornet.
From hip-hop dancing to starring and producing films, he's an actor, choreographer, author, and speaker. Darren DeWitt Henson has paved a steady path to success with discipline, tenacity, and reinvention. Henson's work has garnered worldwide notoriety with numerous film, television, and choreography credits. Henson's most recognized work include acting films such as Stump the Yard, The Express, and Black Coffee. Henson is perhaps best known for his portrayal of Lim Van Adams on Showtime's hit television series, Soul Food. His current role as Orlando Duncan in BET's series, Carl Weber's The Family Business, continues his progressive rise in the entertainment industry. Henson's achievements include an MTV Music Award and an NAACP Image Award. Taking on new challenges and ways to express himself, Henson recently authored a book entitled Intimate Thoughts and the Spirit. Everyone, please join me in giving a Harrisstowe State University Hornet Nation welcome to our keynote speaker, Mr. Darren DeWitt Henson.
Greetings, everyone. How are you feeling? It's beautiful to be here. I'm gonna say yes right now. And I'm gonna get something out of the way real quick, because I know a lot of you, when you saw me come in, this is to the graduating class, you wanted to say something. So I'm gonna let you say it one time. We're gonna get one bootlicker out of the way right now. So on the count of three, bootlicker, we could get that out of the way. One, two, three. There we go, you got it out of the way. I want to say grand rising to you, because you rose out of bed this morning like the sun. And we started off strong. And I thought about that today, and I thought about Cardi B. And I said, it's fitting for you right now. Because in the words of Cardi B's hottest song, and it's up, and it's up, and it's up, right? Come on now. She said, hey, there we go. Hey. I wanted to start off by greeting you and let you know that I honor you, say grand rising to you, and I would like to introduce you to someone that you may not have recognized, but you are familiar with. I want you to turn to the person to the left of you or to the right of you. I want you to look them in their eye and to extend your hand to them right now. And I want you to say from your heart and with all truth, say to them, it is nice to meet an original. Think about that. You are an original. When we look at the word original, it means created personally and directed by a specific artist, not a copy or an imitation. You are not a copy or an imitation. You have been crafted by the hand of the Most High. I'm gonna say that again. You have been crafted by the hand of the Most High God. You are an original. When you first walked through these doors of Harris Stowe, little did you know that you were getting ready to go through a process of pressure that would immediately be applied to you. And like all diamonds, when they're under pressure for a period of time, they start to shine. You started to shine. You started to glow. So you realized that you started to go through it because you were growing through it, so you could glow through it. We go through it so we can grow through it, so we can ultimately glow through it. Amen? A vision was being instilled in you, and that vision created a pregnancy, male and female. We became pregnant with thought, and that thought would birth a responsibility in you. Responsibility is such a powerful word that most people run from, but not you. You gave it a new meaning. The meaning that you gave to responsibility was to respond to your ability. You responded to your ability. What was your ability? Whatever you put your mind to. What you decided to do was to focus. You followed one course until you were successful. Or you forgot others that were creating unnecessary stress. Amen? And through that, as young men, as young women, as adults, as people with a purpose, you realize that Almighty God had the ability to shape you and to instill in you whatever He chose to be. And what you found was very simple. You found your passion. Now let me tell you a quick story. When I was growing up, people always asked me, Darren, do you know your purpose in life? And they asked me so much, it paused me. And it made me stop and think and meditate on that. And what I realized, what I didn't have just one purpose. God instilled in me many purposes. And so what I realized was that it was time for me to get passionate about what I had to do on this earth. And the more passionate I became, the more purposes unfolded, just like you. Here in the walls and the halls of Harris Stowe, you are finding and delivering your purposes. So what I'm gonna say to you today, very like when I was a teenager and I dreamed of working with Michael Jackson, and I did, and it was at the time when he had a song out called Dangerous. And it wasn't dangerous in a negative way, but it was a danger in the sharpest way you can imagine. And when I was on that stage with Michael Jackson, dancing and performing and working with him, and as he was singing Dangerous, I knew at that time I had become dangerous. My vision was dangerous. My passion was dangerous. And the purpose was going to lead me to choreographing. I was going to work with Jennifer Lopez. I was going to work with Britney Spears. I was going to work with NSYNC, Justin Timberlake, Prince. And I did all of that. And what I found through that process of elimination was the more passionate I became, the more purposes were unfolding. I started to write scripts. I started to write books. I started to produce TV shows. I started to produce movies. And here I stand to you today, not as a professor, but as a professor, because I'm here to profess to you that you can do anything that you want to do as long as you stay passionate and stay in purpose. So I ask you to stand up one time. Stand up one time. Stand up one time. I want you to repeat after me. Now. 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 N. New. O. Opportunity. W. Window. New opportunity window. That's right now. That's right now. That's right now. I say to the graduating class of 2021, I am proud of you. I honor you. You are beautiful. You are standing tall. You are strong. You are passionate. And you are purposeful. And in my closing, I want you to know this. When you are tired, get passionate. When things seem far away, get passionate. When the load gets heavy, get passionate. And when things start to load up on you and the world seems like it's against you, get passionate, because your passion is tied to your purpose. And there you will always find success. God bless you and thank you.
Let's give him another round of applause, please. Dr. Bradford and Mr. Henson, can I have you to please join me? Mr. Henson, on behalf of the Board of Regents, faculty, staff, and students of Harris Stowe State University, this token is given in appreciation of the message delivered to our graduates today. Again, we thank you for sharing your encouraging words and spending your birthday weekend with us. At this time, I would like to introduce the 2021 Distinguished Alumni Awardee, Mr. Maurice Bell, member of the class of 1949. Let's give him a round of applause. Let's give him a round of applause. 1949. One more time, let's give him a round of applause. And I urge each and every one of you to consult the section of your program which presents a brief biography of our awardee. Now, I would like to recognize the Harris Stowe State University graduating class of 1971. Not 21, 71. Joining us today is a representative of the class, Mr. Frederick Bond Jr. Please stand. He is representing a group of alumni who are celebrating their 50-year graduation anniversary from Harris Stowe State University. Thank you, Mr. Bond, for being with us today. Now, the moment you have all been waiting for. Will the candidates for the degree of Bachelor of Science please rise? And the candidates for Bachelors of Arts, please rise. That's everybody. All right. Dr. Bradford, I have the great honor and privilege of presenting to you today the candidates for the degree of Bachelors of Science and Bachelor of Arts in the degree programs of Accounting, Business Administration, Finance, Healthcare Management, Information Systems and Technology, Biology, Communications, Criminal Justice, General Studies, Mathematics, Political Science, Sociology, Sustainability and Urban Ecology, and Urban Affairs and Teacher Education, which includes Early Childhood Education, Elementary Education, Middle School Education, Secondary Education, and Educational Studies. On behalf of the faculty and administration of Harris Stowe State University, I certify that each candidate whose name shall hereafter be called has satisfactorily met and fulfilled all of the requirements for the degree of Bachelor of Science in his or her degree program, as specified by the State of Missouri, the Board of Regents of the Harris Stowe State University, and by the faculty and administration of this university. I am therefore greatly pleased to recommend that the degree of Bachelor of Science and or Bachelor of Arts be proudly announced and conferred upon each one of these candidates with the specific academic honors identified with his or her name, as will be announced later as of the date cited in the official program. Graduates, you may be seated. Before we call the graduates to the stage to receive their diploma, I would like to remind the audience to please remain in your seats until the entire ceremony is over and the graduates have processed from the gymnasium. I am happy to announce that an official photographer has been commissioned to take each graduate's photo as he or she is congratulated by the president. Will Dr. Stacy G. Hollins, Dean of the Anheuser-Busch School of Business, please come to the podium to present the candidates for the Anheuser-Busch School of Business.
Will the graduates with the degrees of business, of Bachelor of Science in Accounting, Business Administration, Finance, Healthcare Management, and Information Systems and Computer Technology, please rise and ascend the platform as I call your names to receive your diploma. Christopher Ramel Jackson. Cornelius McIntosh. Matthew Christian Janicek. Russell Myers. Eric D. Melton, Jr. Yvette Washington. Ayana Muhammad. Jasmine Janae Keeley. Amari N. Cunningham. Tarshia Page. William Britton Berger. Lamar S. Merriweather, Jr. Malik Darius Shumpert. Jamari Robinson. Dejanique Nicole Clay. Aaliyah Nicole Augustine. Tyler Danielle Joy. Emma India Ivory. Nathan Joseph Morrow, Jr. LaShay Nicole Caesar. Bryant Michael Harris Williams. Monique Bridges. Teresa Renee Oliver. Alexis Ray Davis. Unique Connor. Caitlin Aaliyah Chandler.
You may be seated. Let's give them a round of applause. Will Dr. Terry Daly Davis, Interim Dean of the College of Arts and Sciences, please come to the podium to present the candidates from the College of Arts and Sciences.
Graduates with the degrees of Bachelor of Science in Biology, Communications, Criminal Justice, General Studies, Mathematics, Political Science, Psychology, Sociology, Sustainability and Urban Ecology, and Urban Affairs, please rise and ascend to the platform as I call your names to receive your diplomas. Rayana Marche Maxwell. Brianna Miller, cum laude. Charday Blandon, summa cum laude. Sharon Denise Ingram, summa cum laude. Maria N. Driver. Thank you. Jamara Jones, cum laude. Alexis Ray James. Antoinisha Renee Murray, summa cum laude. Lasharne Andrea Pearson, cum laude. Johnson. Sabit Gottluck. Dylan Anya Beverly. Jayla Danae Johnson, magna cum laude. Ramaya Buford. Demontez Cardia Lander. Jessica Johnson. Kyron Holloway, magna cum laude. Drake L. Jackson. Benson Alexander Miles. Shanice L. Sharp, magna cum laude. Shaquetta Moats Bernard. Wanisha Edwards, cum laude. Alexandria Elise Spring, summa cum laude. Kamani Tajay Sweeney. Brittany Ines Turner. Aaron Michaela Baskin, magna cum laude. Desiree Renee Williams. Dawn Rowan, cum laude. Jasmine Patrice Mosby, magna cum laude. Yarmin Kirksey. Dwayne Maurice Moore. Hannah Adele Schiffhauer. Elizabeth McKenna Berger. Alyssa Marie Inslee, magna cum laude. Georgia Stefani Harrington, summa cum laude. Ashley Victoria Johnson. Ariana M. Morris, cum laude. Nicole Reed Adewale, summa cum laude. Janae L. Miller. Paris Iman Nicole Brown. Taylor Nixon. Say one vowel. Cambry Mara Davison. Chanel Shanae Gow. Rolina Williams. Thank you. Shara Parker, magna cum laude. Alini Agnes, summa cum laude. Akika Serrana Carruthers. Jasmine Nicole Blackburn, cum laude. Nakisa Aletha Stokes. Makita Marche Clemens. Adora, cum laude. LaRon D. Arnold. Marquise Anton Evans. DeMarcus William Turner. Nakaya Reeves. Clifton Deshaun Price. Shanye Blandon. Diamond Delonia King, summa cum laude.
You may be seated. Let's give them another round of applause. Will Dr. Edward Hill Jr., Associate Provost for Academic Affairs, please come to the podium to present the candidates from the College of Education.
Will the graduates with the degrees of a Bachelor of Science in Education, which includes early childhood, elementary education, middle school education, educational studies, secondary education, please rise, ascend to the platform as I call your names to receive your diplomas. Larche Charisse Carmel McDonald. Denise Poplar, magna cum laude. Rachel Quinn Taylor, summa cum laude. Dejean Nicole York.
Will all the candidates rise? Now, by the authority vested in me by the state of Missouri and the powers granted to me by the Board of Regents of Harris Stowe State University, I hereby confer upon each of you the Bachelor's of Science degree and the Bachelor's of Arts degree cited above your name in the printed program, with all the rights, privileges, and responsibilities thereunto appertaining. Graduates, congratulations! You may now move your tassels from the right to the left. Congratulations, class of 2021. Give it up, Harris Stowe.
Congratulations to all of you again. Give yourselves another round of applause. Graduates, please remain standing. Will Ms. Shirley Brown, President of the Alumni Association, please come to the podium?
Good morning, everyone. It is now my pleasure, as president of the Harris Stowe State University Alumni Association, where the graduates are already standing, but we want you to repeat after me the oath of membership of the Harris Stowe State University Alumni Association. As graduates, you are now a member of the Harris Stowe State University Alumni Association. We welcome you and count on your participation. You have a one-year free membership given to you by the Alumni Association, so please use it and join us. Now repeat after me. As a proud and grateful graduate of Harris Stowe State University, I accept full membership in this institution's long-standing Alumni Association. In doing so, I pledge my unwavering commitment to and support of the ideals and purposes of this historic institution of higher learning. I shall work diligently and cooperatively within the within the association. This I most solemnly promise and declare. Congratulations. You may now be seated.
Now, congratulations, alumni. Just a few closing instructions. Please join in the singing of the Harrisville alma mater. The words and music were written by St. Louis's very own Julius K. Hunter and are located on the screens. Ms. Jerry Washington, Harrisville State University alum, will lead us in song. Immediately following the alma mater, Reverend Tracy D. Blackman will pronounce the benediction. You may then take your seats and remain seated until all groups have processed from the gymnasium in the following order: the platform guests, followed by the faculty and staff, and finally the graduates. Everyone is invited to join us for a grab and go COVID-19 friendly reception in honor of our graduates in the university's quad immediately following the ceremony. After the graduates complete their degree process, they will join you there. Thank you all for joining us for this wonderful celebration. Now, please stand for the singing of the alma mater by Ms. Jerry Washington, Harrisville State University alum.
I'll sing of Harrisville.
Just a moment of personal privilege. I want to thank Dr. Bradford for letting me be a part of today and to witness something that's been very emotional for me, especially in the midst of a pandemic, the pandemic of COVID-19, the continuing pandemic of COVID-16-19, and the COVID pandemic of 45 that we're still recovering from. I want to begin your benediction with the words from my favorite revolutionary poet, Lucille Clifton, just the closing line of her poem, written to black people all over America, "Come celebrate with me that every day something has tried to kill us, and every day it has failed." The benediction. May God, who began a good work in you, carry it through to completion, enabling you to use your talents and your gifts to the fullest. May God give you the grace to make wise choices and to be faithful to your commitment, always confident in the support of those who love you. May God bless you with discomfort and easy answers and half-truths and superficial relationships so that you will live deep within your heart. May God bless you with anger at injustice, oppression, and exploitation of people so that you will work for justice, equity, and peace. May God bless you with tears to shed for those who suffer from pain, rejection, starvation, and war, so that you will use your power to fight for them and help change their trials into triumphs. May God bless you with enough foolishness to think that you can make a difference in the world so that you will do all the things that other folk tell you cannot be done. May your integrity be a gift to the world, and may the Spirit of God be with you always. And may you always be accompanied by the spirit of our ancestors, who remind us to never let the messages of this world convince us that what our faith has told us is not true. Go from this place, graduates, and own all of your space in this world. Amen.